Rates of mental illness right now during the pandemic are increasing dramatically, and I want to show you a little bit of the data that supports that increase. There's an organization known as Mental Health America, and they provide free online screenings for all sorts of mental illnesses. So you can go to this website and find a test to determine whether you're clinically depressed, or whether you have generalized anxiety disorder, whether you have bipolar disorder, PTSD, psychosis, an eating disorder, postpartum depression. And the folks who run these websites keep track anonymously of the answers that people give to various questions over time. And in this way, they can assess how mental health changes over time. So I'm going to show you some data that they've collected during the year 2020. And 6 million people completed one or more screenings on the Mental Health America website during this period. So we're talking about lots and lots of data. This graph, the vertical axis, tells you the number of people who, according to a screening, are experiencing depression, anxiety, or psychosis. Each color, each box is a different mental illness. And what I want you to see is that since the COVID pandemic started, really got going in April, rates of depression, rates of anxiety, rates of psychosis are increasing significantly in the US. These are very troubling trends. What are the triggers to the mental health problems that people are experiencing now? And you might think that the triggers would be economic instability, concerns about physical health, but really the things that responders are reporting is that they're incredibly lonely and isolated. Almost 75% of the people who complete these screenings report feeling very lonely and very isolated. Now, past trauma is also very common. 46% of screeners report past traumas. But remember, it can be a combination of things. So you could be going along in life and have past trauma, but then when something, a major stressor hits, that combination of events is enough to push you over into having a clinical level of mental illness. This is my last slide. I just want to point out that the people experiencing the biggest problems right now with anxiety and depression are high school, college age students. So people between the ages of 18 and about 25, even young teenagers are experiencing bigger problems. I'm showing you these slides now to say that I know that many of you watching this video during the pandemic are struggling with depression and or anxiety. Sometimes they come along together. And I want to encourage you strongly to go to our website, look at all of the resources that I've listed. I've listed the website for Mental Health America. Figure out, you know, what's happening with you and reach out to get help. There's help available all over the place. CSUN has a terrific mental health center with fabulous therapists. And as a CSUN student, they are there waiting to help you. So reach out and get help. You don't need to go through this alone. Thanks for your attention.